which is 100 microns. Again, it is not sensitive, but definitely we notice a red X component, a troublesome component, which is the output matching network R1. That resistor is causing big problems in my yield. It is the main cause of that yield, that resistor, basically. So what do? We fix that problem. As I said, we either reduce its value and control its tolerance. But one thing I want to show you about this template that you will be using, it's already in ADS. One thing is, in the top equation, the total yield is the gain yield times the noise figure yield times the S22 yield. Let me, for example, take the S22 yield completely out. So now I'm not looking at the S22 yield. I just look at the gain and noise figure. And notice the display did not change. Why? Because the S22 yield was okay. The resistor R1 did not affect the S22 yield. But now let's take the noise figure yield out and only look at the gain yield. Look at this. Now my yield becomes 100% if the resistor is 20 ohms or lower, but it still goes to zero if the resistor goes plus 5%. So there's something that has to do with the gain. Notice that if the resistor is greater than 20 ohms, 5% greater, my gain gets lower than the spec, and this is why it drops down to zero, the yield. Okay, there is another way I can show you this. By the way, look, I am back to gain, noise figure, and S22 yield. The other way is the specs here. Notice on the bottom, I have noise figure, minimum spec, and maximum spec. Gain, minimum spec, and maximum spec. And S22, minimum spec, and maximum spec. Notice the noise figure spec, I have a maximum of 1.85. Let me relax that spec. Instead of 1.85, let me relax that spec and use 2 dB. Now notice what happened. Because I use 2 dB noise figure spec, automatically my yield improved, but still, because of the resistor with the gain, still at the high end, it's dropped to zero. Now let me go to the gain and relax it and say, I'll settle with 10 dB gain. Let me put 10 dB gain and look what happened now. Now I have 100% yield in my circuit. By the way, by changing these specs on the bottom and updating the yield, you do not have to run yield analysis again, because the yield data are already stored in ADS data set, in the data set, and they encompass all the simulation factors. So you don't have to redo the whole simulations every time you want to change the spec. This template already has the data specs, and you can change them here and the yield will update automatically. This tool right here is great for system designers, because system designers can change the specs, relax specs, or make it tighter and see if they can still use that design on their system or they need to relax it more. Okay, the way to go is now to keep my specs the way they are, because these are my specs. I'm not gonna mess with them or change them. And now my goal is to fix my circuit to get 100% yield. And as I mentioned to you before, the way to do that is to fix the resistor R1, because this is the sensitive component, and try to make it a fat resistor to have its tolerance be plus or minus 1%. And if I do this, I can go to ADS and I can look at the final design. Okay, this is my final design, and if I look at the resistor now R1 in this design, let me zoom further on it. Notice that I changed that resistor to lower value 17, and I put plus or minus 3% by making it much wider in the layout, plus or minus 3% here. By doing this and rerun the analysis, the yield analysis, now I can look at the data set that has this results. And notice now I have this data set, the fixed LNA, and notice now the R1 is giving me, to the same specs I have, is giving me 100% yield. And I can change any component I want. Here C1, I'm getting 100% yield. I can change this to input matching network, C1, and I get 100% yield. And any components, basically. So we fixed the problem by finding where is the red X component element in it, and we took care of it. Again, it's like an X-ray machine. The X-ray machine told me exactly where the problem is. It is right here, R1, the resistor R1. Fix it, make sure that it doesn't vary a lot by making it wider in the layout, and you will have a much better yield. And look, now when I go to manufacturing and I fabricate this circuit, it will have much higher yield, 100% yield, and it will meet first pass success. Thank you very much for watching this presentation and demo, and I hope you enjoyed it, and I encourage you to go to ADS 2008 Update 2 Example Directory, Microwave Circuits Example Directory, and pull this example. It's a KU band DFM, designed for manufacturing example, and just play with the circuits, run it. If you run and hit simulate, automatically the display comes out, see the setup and see the outputs, and just familiarize yourself with these great techniques that will ensure that you will get first pass success with very high yield if you use those tools in ADS. So thank you very much.